My 2-year cell phone commitment ended a couple of weeks ago. I took the time to review all of the exciting new phones, and this phone is what my wife selected, the new iPhone 11 Pro Max, a very nice choice. She chose this one for two reasons. She loves iPhones, and this is the latest and greatest version. I chose a different phone. I have a link in the description for that unboxing. So this phone plus the Apple Watch Series 5 are what I'm unboxing today, beginning with the phone. The color options on this phone are space gray, silver, gold, and midnight green. This one is space gray. It has 4 gigabytes of RAM and 64 gigabytes of storage. My wife has 64 gigabytes of storage on her current phone without any problems. It has 18 watt fast charging, 50% in 30 minutes. QI wireless charging is available as an optional accessory. Look at that. This phone has a 6.5-inch Super Retina XDR OLED capacitive touchscreen, 1242 by 2688. With 458 ppi, that looks gorgeous. It has HDR10 and Dolby Vision. Next, it has triple 12 megapixel camera, main cameras on the back, wide, telephoto, and ultra wide. The selfie camera is also 12 megapixel. Both main and selfie cameras can take 4K 60fps videos. The main camera can also record HDR with stereo sound. The iPhone camera software is among the best. Next, stereo speakers, both on the bottom. It has a non-removable 3969 milliamp battery, easily good for a full day of use. Next, it has Face ID unlock and touchpad unlock, but it does not have fingerprint unlock on the screen or on the back. There's also no heart rate sensor, just like other iPhones. However, it looks like the industry is moving away from that feature on phones, as almost none of the new phones this year have a heart rate sensor. I guess Apple was ahead of the curve. If you want a heart rate sensor, just pick up an Apple Watch Series 5. It has dual rate sensors, the watch, for more accuracy. It integrates seamlessly with the iPhone. You may want to get a screen protector for this phone because its display is not Corning Gorilla Glass 6, and other videos are showing that it's not too hard to scratch it. We got some stickers, other junk here. We have the 18 watt charger. Like, we have some earbuds and the charging cable in the box. That's all that's in the box. A Okay, this is just a quick unboxing video. So let's take a look at the watch. My wife chose to upgrade her Apple Watch Series 3 to the new Series 5. This watch is the 40 millimeter version in a gold aluminum case with a pink sand sport band. Inside the box includes a charging cable and USB power adapter. Okay, these are the bands. As long and short for your wrist size. Here's the watch. It has 32 gigabytes of storage. That's more than enough for a watch. It's water resistant to 50 meters. It has GPS. This one does not have LTE. It has a very good heart rate sensor. The sensor on my wife's Series 3 watch has proven to be much more accurate than the one on my Galaxy watch. And this new Series 5 watch is even better with two heart rate sensors, optical and electrical. There's two sensors in here. It has more watch faces than previous models, but much fewer than the Galaxy watches have. My wife loves her old Series 3 watch and is eagerly looking forward to this new one. It's improved in almost every way. If you're a fan of the Apple ecosystem, then these two devices go together like ham and eggs. They are the best representations of Apple's product line to date. Now I've got to put them back in the box, wrap them up, and put them under the Christmas tree for my wife. I hope she won't be too mad at me about my little unboxing. Please like and subscribe if you're contemplating a phone purchase in the near future. I hope you'll also watch my video of the phone that I chose, the Asus ROG Gaming Phone 2.